All right, the verdict, as you well know, was handed down Friday in the Danziger trial. Five former New Orleans police officers were convicted for their roles in the deaths of two people on the bridge in those days after Hurricane Katrina. But of course, now the big question a lot of people want to know, what is next? So we're joined now live right now with our reporter, Gina Swanson, who followed the trial from the very beginning. She's with us right now. All right, Gina, so break it down for us. Where do we go from here?
You know, there's been a lot of talk about New Orleans Police Department and exactly what may be next. But we know in March that the Justice Department came out with this scathing report about reforms that the NOPD needed to make, including there were talks of issuing a consent decree. But we do know when it comes to the Danziger trial, there is one more person who still has to go on trial. So the federal government kind of has put that to consent decree on hold as not to taint any of the legal proceedings coming up. So definitely still lots of involvement by the federal government. Certainly a huge win for the government, but things are far from over when it comes to the New Orleans Police Department.
And we're hearing a lot about appeals, possible appeals too.
There absolutely are appeals. And you know what? Since the federal government has started looking into this, there have been more than a half dozen investigations, more than 20 current or former officers accused of wrongdoing, still some prosecution pending, still more cases coming up. So they just want to make sure that they have everything buttoned up before moving forward with any type of government or federal oversight, Camille.
And separate cases we're talking about.
Separate cases. Yeah, absolutely. There's the Broomfield case outside of the convention center. We know we already had the Henry Glover case. They're looking into the Adolph Grimes case where officers where Adolph Grimes was killed on New Year's at the hands of a police officer. So still a lot of probes going on with NOPD.
Gina, what's your feel on how the community is responding to all this?
You know, we actually talked to one community watchdog group that monitors police activity. They do tell us that while they are happy that the family still got some justice, there's still, as we mentioned, several more cases to go. And they say that NOPD has a long way to go before they can restore public trust. So they're still keeping a close eye on things. Camille.
All right, Gina, with that insight, thank you so much. We'll see you again in later news.